Okay, you guys, so we're back.
So we're gonna go ahead and make manioque tama.
Okay, so let's start by, I'm using this from Goya, grated yuca. That's what I'm using. These are like $4.99. And this is the two pound package. This is the cassava in here. So looks like that. This is frozen cassava. And I have shredded coconut. This is the real frozen shredded coconut. I'm gonna put this in here. This is real shredded coconut. Look at that. That looks so good. Very fresh. So we'll put two of these. So I have 5 packages of cassava in there, two pound packages. And this is an 8 ounce coconut, real coconut. Go ahead and mix this. Okay, and in here we're gonna add tapioca starch. Tapioca starch. Okay, we'll add 2 of these in here. Okay, and we're gonna go ahead and mix that up and just make sure everything is mixed together very well. Just mix everything together. Okay, so in this, we're gonna pour our coconut milk. Okay, This is 3 cups right here. So the you want the corn, the tapioca starch and the cassava mix to mix very well, along with the coconut, shredded coconut in there. I got like really thick coconut here. Just break it apart. Hey, you guys, that's it. That's the ingredients right there. So we can have 2 pans of this. Okay, Gonna go ahead and stick this in a 400 degree oven for about, we'll check it in an hour. All right, be right back. Okay, you guys, our manioc tamales in the oven. Got one more here to put in. So be right back, okay? Go ahead and add in one more cup of water in here. That's our second one. Okay, let's see if this is ready. Hi guys, okay, so our manioc tama is ready. This is what it looks like. Looks great. And here's the front of it. And you can really see the coconut.
Let's go ahead and cut this up. Guys, welcome back. How are you guys? As a manioke dama is ready. Just get your lolo and use it to cut these into cubes. So you can see the coconut inside. The coconut inside. Just to cut it. Come say hi.
Hello.
Svatai. She just wanted to stop in and say hello. Did I turn that down?
Get that.
Looks really good, guys. Like a Thai Lolo on it. So, so delicious. I just dipped it in my Lolo. You guys, hope you try it. It's so ifo. Ifo, ifo. This is my manioque tama. My Lolo, guys. Lolo is so evil. Look at the texture. Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I was thinking of that.
Guys, I just want you to see how beautiful our manioque tama is right there. Everything looks so nice and beautiful. You can see the coconut in there. This is turned out really, really well. I want you to go look at the texture. There was one viewer who requested manioque tama. This one's for you. Helps when you make yours. I find the scissors works for me best to cut rather than the knife. And then you have the crust on there. You can go ahead and cut that off, separate that. So my Lolo made out of coconut milk. There, dunk it in there. Grab one and dunk it. That's homemade Lolo.
And it tastes just like regular.
Yeah. That's homemade Lolo.
My my eyes started to go.
You make it a bowl though, right?
Does that ever happen to you?
What?
When you're just like standing blankly and
you're like, oh yeah, like I'm recording and that's happened to me. I'm like, oops.
Your eyes go like,
I need to get back on my game.
Can I try one of the...
Yeah, the crunchy one? Yeah. Here, take it. Break it in half. Just break it.
This is so
lucky, I caught it.
I thought that was a nail.
Oh.
This is too crunchy.
Yeah. Yeah, I like the just the middle of it.
So some of them still have a little
bit. Want another
bit.
One, hon?
Just kidding. No.
Where in her?
Yeah, diarrhea.
Yeah, you're right. And that sweetness, too.
She heard me say that. That's what she's saying.
Everything?
Uh-huh.
And I eat sick
after? Uh-huh. You know where
I'm going with this?
Yeah.
Give
Nedu.
I have to wash my hands.
Okay, so let's go ahead and add the Lolo. Manioketama. That is perfect. That is delicious. Hope you guys try it. Okay, so that's our manioque tama by Kakai. You lost your opportunity to go out there. Aww, you okay? You okay, Neji? We're making otai, taking otai meleni. So we have our watermelon here. We have our half and half. I have my green old house, green goodness. And we have some leftover mighty mango from the mango otai. So go ahead and make this. Oh, Okay, you guys, it's such a beautiful day out today. I am loving it. Okay, let's cut these. Watermelon otai can be made in several different ways. The cook is always full because this is what they do. Go ahead and just pour it in so it can blend. Here's the mango, mighty mango. Okay. All right, you guys. This is the tedious part, is shredding it. And this is the making of the otai. When you put it in a blender, it's going to be exactly like a smoothie, but when you shred it like this, then it is traditional otai. And there's, I think the mango you can kind of get away with using the blender, but the watermelon, you don't want to really mix it in the blender too much. If for the mango, you want to just probably pulse it. Pulse would be good. Because you still want the otai is when you can chew your fruit, when you can chew it. But when it's like you just swallow it down, and you're looking at a smoothie right there. But yeah. So right now we have our loo in the oven, and we have our manioke tama in the oven. And the more you make the watermelon otai, the faster you'll get it. You'll find it won't take long at all. to make a quick otari out of watermelon. I like the green apple otai, but it is time consuming because you have to peel, and the mango is time consuming too because you gotta peel the skin. I have my daughter's dog here, and I love her, to death. Her name is Neji, and you've probably seen from my videos that we go for little walks. And while she's visiting, but I love her. She's here and she's laying down in the living room. Such a good dog. She's a pit bull, half pit bull, half something else. I don't really know, but I know she's a pit bull. Come on, Mitchie. I bought her a little ice cream treat. It's an ice cream treat that they get. And the ice cream is all melted. So she's like drinking it like it's milk. I get her all little treats, but she's very little to eat. But she's such a good dog. She wants to go outside. And there's this dog in our neighbor's dog. I guess it's a male. And she is so in love with that dog. And there's a space between our the neighbor's dog, the neighbor's fence, and the other fence. There's a space, and once she gets out, she will go over there to try to get into that fence. But and then she will not listen to us to come out. There's two cans for a container like this. I use two cans of crushed pineapple. And make sure you look for the pineapple juice, 100%. Get all of that out. And coconut, that same one I put in the manioque tamba. I'm gonna put this into this is fresh coconut, frozen coconut, but it's all coconut, no preservatives to keep it fresh. So that's gonna be like, an ice block in there. Let's go ahead and add some sugar. There's one, two cups of sugar. And those are the ingredients for otai. That's it. Right now I'm just trying to get the frozen coconut, frozen shredded coconut to melt, and once it melts, it'll be perfect. Be ready to eat. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and give this a taste. That is delicious, guys. Okay. So, Otai is ready. Let's close that up. Okay, you guys. Hope you guys have a great day. Stay blessed. And we'll see you in the next video. Ofato.